Good morning, quarter to five. We have rain potential, just not so much today. Yes, it's a misty, foggy, drippy, drizzly, damp out there this morning. It's tomorrow when we're going to get wet. And some of the strongest thunderstorm threats are late tomorrow afternoon into tomorrow night, early Sunday morning, and it looks like we could see 1 to 2 plus inches of rain, some of these big thunderstorms. Yes, in eastern North Dakota. Yes, in central Minnesota. And more so in South Dakota, moving up into central North Dakota. So that's kind of the bird's eye view of what's happening. Today, we start cloudy. By noon, you can start to erode some of the clouds in the northern end of the valley. Temperatures, well, yeah, we'll get well into the 60s, especially, again, we're going to start to get the sun in the north and warmer usually in the south, but the sun is what's going to be the warming factor today, not the wind. Wind will be kind of northeast, northwesterly, but light. But again, so everybody should get well into the 60s, 70, maybe. Then, starting overnight tonight, here comes the rain, showers, and early tomorrow morning, not a whole lot of weather worries here. It's tomorrow afternoon and tomorrow night when we see some thunderstorm potential, some of which could be severe, especially late tomorrow night. And there it is right there out of Western Cass into Steele and Trail and Grand Forks County, tracking northward. So our, again, potential worst weather Saturday is going to be down in the Central Plains, and that's going to swirl up here and widespread rain. And yes, look at there. On the backside of this powerful low is cold air, and that'll create some snow on the high plains of the West River of South Dakota, southwest North Dakota, even up into Manitoba and parts of Ontario, and yes, even parts of the northeast corner of North Dakota, possibly on Sunday night. There's the heaviest rain in the last 24 hours been out in western Stutzman County down in towards the Missouri River Valley. This morning, the rain is gone. The mist droplets are so small, they're not being detected by radar. We have some snow out there around Sheridan, Wyoming, rain in the Black Hills, but a line of thunderstorms from the panhandle of Nebraska down to just west of Hayes, Kansas, is moving northward. That's the leading edge of a whole lot of severe weather, which this morning, again, no severe thunderstorm or we do have ones just popped up there. Looks like a very small one. Must be down there west of San Antonio. Over the weekend, yes, eastern North Dakota, northwest Minnesota under the gun for the most rain. And early and mid part of next week, northeast North Dakota, southeastern Manitoba could see some more significant rainfall again. So we're far from done with the wet weather pattern. Soil temperatures right now in the low 50s, southern end of the valley, mid to upper 40s in the northern valley. So again, yeah, these are the 4 a.m. soil temperatures, thanks to North Dakota Ag Weather Network. Not much for wind, and as a result, we have a collection of moisture here at the surface. Temperatures rather mild, 48 to 52, although a cool 39 can do, but mostly mid to upper 40s out there. For the next couple of days, today we call it becoming partly cloudy. We have opportunity for some shower, thunderstorm potential coming in for tomorrow afternoon and tomorrow night, and a rainy, windy Sunday on the way. All right, coming up after the break, we're taking a look at what the markets are doing early on a Friday morning with Dennis Smith. We'll be right back.